Ah, there you are, Professor.
She's here, Dr. Strauss.
Oh, good. Send her in.
Will you come in, Miss Kinney?
Miss Kinney.
How do you do, Dr. Strauss?
Have you brought him with you?
He's up at the lab with Burge running the tests.
Without my meeting him.
I thought it would save time. Miss Kinnean can fill us in with his background.
Ah, yes. Well, Miss Kinnean?
His name is Charlie Gordon. He's 32, about 5'11", rather nice looking, brown hair and eyes, and he's mentally retarded.
Do you happen to know his IQ?
68.
And how did you meet him?
I teach a night class for retarded adults, and someone at the bakery where he works heard about it and told him. Of course, he couldn't read or write, but on his way home, he bought a newspaper thinking he could read it the next day on the way to school.
Our subject must read and write. We want him to keep a journal of the reaction.
He can now, just at about a third grade level. He's slow, and he sometimes forgets what he's already learned. Rather like those Muslim pilgrims, two steps forward and one step back, but he works so hard, and he's so eager to learn. That's why I wrote to you when I heard about the project.
Now, has he any family?
If he does, he's lost track of them. There was a sister. The family lived in Brooklyn. They may still be there.
Now, if he has any family, we're going to need to contact them if something should go
wrong. So we look for them. How big is Brooklyn?
Exactly what type of experiment is it?
Oh, it's very new.
So far, it's only been done with mice.
Mice?
But it's been very successful. Because a mouse in the lab now, his intelligence has increased threefold and is still growing.
Can you explain it? The operation to me.
It's too complicated for a layman to understand.
Put very simply, we remove the damaged portion of the retarded's brain by surgery, and then through chemical injection, we revitalize the remaining brain tissue, permitting it to produce brain proteins at a supernormal rate.
All right, well, it is too complicated for a layman.
If it's successful, the operation would increase the patient's mental capacity, perhaps to a level of a genius.
Genius? And he'll stay that way permanently?
We have every reason to believe so.
It's worked so far in Algernon.
And who's Algernon?
That's what my lab technicians call the mouse.
And what if something were to go wrong?
He'll be taken care of.
How?
Mr. Kinnean, we would not perceive this operation if we were not reasonably sure of success. However, we are aware of the possibility of failure, and the Wellbrook Foundation, which is sponsoring us, has taken the steps to secure the patient's future in that event.
Perhaps I shouldn't have brought Charlie here.
Oh, there is inevitably some danger in exploring new fields, Miss Kinney, but in every scientific advance, there must be someone who is first.
I know that. It's just a little upsetting when the first person isn't somebody faceless on the front of a newspaper, but someone you know and someone you care about.
Yes, well, if Charlie is chosen and we succeed, then he will have more than a new life. He will have a life. And even if we fail, he'll have made a greater contribution to mankind than most normal people can ever hope to do.
I know that. It's just, Charlie's like a lovable little boy. All he wants, all he ever talks about is to be smart. He's quite incapable of making a decision like this on his own, and I've taken it upon myself. I just hope I'm making the right decision.
Just make yourself comfortable, Charlie.
You want it? I should open my mouth and say ah?
And why would I want that?
Well, that's doctors. Open your mouth and say ah.
Well, I'm not a doctor, Charlie.
But you got a white coat.
This is just because I work in a laboratory, no? Now just relax.
Well, it all is hurts when they say relax.
Hurt, Charlie, it won't hurt. There's nothing to be scared of.
I know. I've got my rabbit's foot.
Good, we're just going to run some tests.
Tests? Well, when I was a kid, I always failed tests. You know, in school.
Charlie, this is a different kind of test. See, it's called a Rorschach test.
A Rorschach test?
Yes, you just look at these cards and tell me what you see.
That's the test?
Yes. Look at this one, Charlie. What might this be? What do you see on this card? People see all sorts of things in these ink blots. Tell me what it makes you think.
Somebody spilled an ink on a white card.
No, Charlie, people see pictures in these ink blots.
Well, where?
You have to find them. Think, Charlie. Imagine there's something there.
Oh. I imagine an ink blot.
Look at this one, Charlie. Pretend it's something. Does it remind you of anything?
Okay. I pretend...
Yes?
I pretend that somebody spilled a bottle of ink on a card.
All right, let's try the other one. Doris, will you bring an Algernon?
Right away, Bert.
We're going to play a game, Charlie. This is called a maze.
Well, I don't see no pictures.
No, Charlie, it's not a test. It's a sort of break, see? There are all these little alleys here, and this mouse has to find his way through all the openings and all the walls and get through to the end here. And then he'll make a bell ring, and then he'll get a prize.
Oh, well, you're kidding. No mouse would find all those holes.
Charlie, this is Algernon.
Hiya. He's cute.
Now, watch. Okay, Algernon. Go.
Whoa! Boy, I didn't know mice were so smart.
Would you like to erase them?
I couldn't fit in there.
Charlie, of course you couldn't. I'll show you how we do it. Arrangement two, please. Now, Charlie, this arrangement is going to be the same as Algernon's maze. So, you're going to take this pin and draw a line from the beginning here until you reach the end here, but you mustn't cross the printed lines.
And whoever gets to the end first wins?
Right.
Okay, but I don't like cheese.
Okay. We'll just see who wins. Ready? Set? Go.
But I can't...
Go back. Find the way.
But, I didn't know mice was so smart.
Well, this one's had a lot of advantages, Charlie.
Well, does that mean I won't get an operation? Because I lost the maze?
Charlie, of course not.
Well, I want that operation real bad. And I can work really hard and watch how the Algernon does the maze. And then I could get smart and do the operation.
We'll see what Professor Niemer says, Charlie.
Well, I'm not afraid of the operation. I'm not afraid of nothing. And besides, I got my lucky rabbit's foot.
I don't know. I simply don't know.
You didn't perform too well on the test.
Well, from a man with a 68 IQ, you wouldn't expect the same results you'd get from Dr. Salk.
He did, however, pass the physical. The doctor said he was a strong...
This is not a tryout for the Olympic team. It's a serious scientific experiment.
I know Charlie is not what you had in mind for your new breed of intellectual supermen, but most people of his low mentality are hostile and uncooperative. They're usually dull, apathetic, and hard to reach.
Charlie's good-natured, interested, and eager
to
please.
This is not a popularity contest. He'll be the first human being to ever have his intelligence increased by certain.
Exactly, and where will we find another mentally retarded adult with this same tremendous capacity to learn?
Charlie reads and writes extremely well.
So he reads and writes. Does he understand?
Does he understand what we're going to do to him and what could happen?
I think so. We explained it very carefully when we interviewed him.
Please, Professor, use him.
Why does it matter so much to you?
Because it matters so much to him! Charlie wants to be smart so badly that you can feel it. If this project has any chance to succeed, it will only succeed with Charlie Gordon.
Maybe you're right. We'll use him.
Yes, hello? Oh, Bert, no, I was just making breakfast. Is it over? Well, how is he? Can they tell the effect it had on his mind? When do you think they'll know? Can I come and visit him tonight at the hospital? Oh, well, will you just let me know as soon as I can get out visitors? Okay, thanks, Bert. Thank you so much for calling.
Charlie, what's the matter?
The anesthetic hasn't quite worn off.
Charlie, wake up, Charlie.
When is the operation?
It's all over, Charlie.
Over?
Yes, Charlie, you've been asleep 18 hours. Pulse normal.
Oh, you done an operation while I was asleep?
Yes, Charlie.
Well, that's a funny thing to do.
Yes, we put you to sleep.
Oh, yeah. You was all dressed up like a doctor's on TV, and you put a funny thing on my nose.
Respiration normal.
How do you feel, Charlie?
I feel fine, but am I smart yet?
No, Charlie, that's not the way it works. It comes slowly, and you have to work very hard to get smart.
Well, what I need operations for?
Well, now, Charlie, when you learn something, it will stick with you, not the way it was before.
Well, I thought I was gonna be smart right away. And then I could see my friends at the bakery, Frank and Joe, and we could laugh about jokes and make fun of the president and how he makes dumb mistakes and all. And when you're smart, you have lots of friends and you never get lonely all by yourself all the time.
Yes, you go, Charlie, in time. Now, look, I brought you a present.
Well, gee, thanks. What is it?
It's a notebook, and every day I want you to write in it.
Write what?
Well, we'll call it a progress report.
Progress report?
Progress report.
Progress.
I want you to put the date on the top and write everything you feel and think about and remember from the past.
I don't remember so good.
Just do the best you can. By reading this, we'll know what's going on in your mind.
But I don't know what's going on in my mind, so how can you?
Just trust me.
I'd like to check his motor responses.
Charlie, do you feel able to walk?
Yeah. I can walk good thanks to the operation. Well, I could always walk good.
Bert, why don't you take him for a walk down the corridor? Of course. Come down, Charlie.
Doctor, can I go back to work soon?
You'd like to?
Yeah, I want to see my friends at the bakery. And maybe I can find my mom and dad, too. They always wanted me to be smart.
We'll see. Just try and walk now, Charlie.
My mom always wanted me to be smart. And if they saw a smart guy, I wouldn't have to go away no more. Oh, Bert? Did you have to walk Algernon when he got operations?
Should we be sending him back to work?
I think so. In a few days, he seems perfectly fine.
What about the tests and therapy and progress reports?
Yes, he'll have to keep coming back to the lab to continue those. He can continue with Bert with the tests, and he can start therapy with me. 2 hours a night should do it, and the progress reports will do in his own time.
Don't you think it's too much activity for him? After all, he's had a serious operation.
Well, he might be tired for a little while, but I think on the whole it's better for him to remain in his own environment. He feels safe at the bakery. His friends are there.
Doctor, may I change plans?
Suppose Charlie doesn't want to come to therapy.
Suppose he won't come to the progress report. Oh, Charlie will want to. Besides, we'll pay him. There's money in the budget for that.
I suppose you're right, but we should warn Charlie not to tell anyone the exact nature of the operation.
People might not understand it. It might make life even more difficult for him. We don't want people treating him like some kind of freak.
Which, of course, is what we might have made him.
That's not a very scientific attitude, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I sometimes slip back and think like a human being.
That's sentimentalizing. What we have done, if it works, will push forward the boundaries of human knowledge and help untold numbers of people.
Yes, it just seems to me that a human's life is more delicate to deal with than mouses.
March 15th. Progress report. Progress report. When I waked it up this morning, I thought I was gonna be smart. But I'm not. And maybe the operation didn't work. And they'll give up on me. At least then, I wouldn't have to run the amazed no more. I hate Algernon. Algernon can't help he's a smart mouse. He had the same operation as me. I bet I could do the amazed, faster than a regular mouse. Bert says, don't be Bert says, it took a long time, Algernon got smart. And I can go back to work today, but I dasn't tell anybody what kind of operation they've done, or else they maybe laugh. Your friend, Charlie Gordon.
Frank, what'd you do with my eclairs, Frank?
I filled them like you told me. How many times I gotta fill them?
What is it? What is it already? Let's really scare away our customers. Shouldn't happen.
This is Donovan, with a second baker like Frank. I don't need enemies. What are you doing working for the bakery down the street?
I filled your rotten eclairs.
Yeah, you filled them with a lemon meringue pie filling.
I keep telling you, Frank, keep your mind on your
own. Oh, what mind? Put her in Charlie Gordon there, Frank.
Oh, I was going to say that I was one of God's creatures. Now, Gina, make a sign. Say special. Lemon creamy clairs. There, it's all set.
What am I gonna do with all the meringue?
Oh, look, speaking of the devil, it's Charlie. Darling, you're fair. Oh, can I have a cup of coffee or a jelly donut or something fresh from the oven?
You look good, kid.
What'd they do, Charlie? Put some brains in
there? Fucking brains. Maybe an operation. Maybe you'll put that custom
wearable on. Come on, Frank, I've got some birthday cake back here. This time, try to remember birthday spelled with an I. And hey, I know it's your birthday. Try not to steal one of them, please.
Hey, glad to have you back, Charlie. The place ain't gonna have to last without you.
Well, thanks, Frank.
Yeah, you're looking real good, Charlie. What'd they do to you?
Well, they put me to sleep, and then they took
right,
they operation on me, and that's it.
You all right, darling? Tell me.
I'm fine, Mrs. Donner. But where's the deliveries at?
Oh, Gina, make a sign, Charlie. Darling,
you're not going to
be delivered
before you want. Oh, but I always
deliver. Oh, always deliver. Good, never a mistake. But while you're gone, I need someone to drag the cakes around. So I got a nice boy, Aaron, and you'll like him. So I thought you should rest up from your operation, and you'll sweep up like always, and they're in your way.
No, I'm okay, Mrs. Donner, really. I can clean up and do the deliveries. What do you need an Ernie for?
He needs the money, Charlie. I'll keep him on as an apprentice to land him to be a baker, and you know, you can be his assistant and help him on deliveries now on Saturdays and Thanksgiving and all that.
I never was an assistant before.
How long have you been here, Charlie? 17 years, Charlie. 17 years ago, your Uncle Herman brought you to my Sam, God rest his soul, and asked for you to work here. But when your Uncle Herman died and your mother came into that warren place, Sam signed for you. He got you out. And Sam's promise is my promise. Now, from the bakery business, I'll never be a millionaire, but you've got a job here for the rest of your life.
Well, Mrs. Donner, if I work really hard, can I learn to be an apprentice baker like that Ernie kid?
Don't worry about it, Charlie. Just remember, you will never, ever have to go back to that warm place. You hear me? Now, why was that place?
Been to the lab in more than a week, Charlie.
It's very important to you and our work, Charlie. Do you understand?
I don't want to race the Algernon no more.
All right, you won't have to, but you'll have to start going to therapy sessions with Dr. Strauss.
What's therapy?
Well, Charlie, therapy is, you come into my office and you sit on my chair and you talk about what you think, what you feel about your dreams.
I don't have no dreams.
Oh, you will. Therapy is when you feel bad, you talk about it, and that makes it better.
But I don't feel bad. And besides, I do plenty of talking all day to the bakery. So why I gotta come to therapy for?
Because we say so, Charlie. Now, we're loaning you this teaching machine.
Machine? If I'm gonna be teacher, I wanna go to Miss Kinnean's class.
Miss Kinnean will be coming to the center to teach you special.
especially.
Yeah, when?
Soon. Meanwhile, you'll use the machine. Now, it works something like a radio. It makes sounds and it talks, and every day I want you to put it on just before you go to sleep.
Why should I turn on the radio before I go to sleep?
Because we say so, Charlie.
Why? What's it gonna
do? Do as we say, Charlie.
No, explain me why.
He's beginning to question authority.
Look, Charlie, this machine can do many things for your mind.
Teach you things while you're sleepy, and as you fall asleep, it'll make you have dreams, make you remember things from your past.
Well, why do I gotta get smart when I'm asleep? I wanna get smart when I'm awake.
Well, Charlie, you have two minds, the conscious and the subconscious. This machine will teach your conscious mind while you're awake, and then it will stir up memories in your subconscious while you're asleep.
If I gotta get smart for two minds, I'm never gonna get smart.
Well, Charlie, you're getting smart all the time. It's just moving so slowly now you don't see it. Oh, but it's moving, Charlie. It's sort of like the hour hand on a clock. Soon you're going to be a very intelligent young man, Charlie.
Yes.
And use the machine.
I never learned nothing listening to late night radio shows. And they was more interesting than you.
Times 6 is 12. 8 times 2 is 16. 8 times 3 is 24.
Well, how am I supposed to get any sleep with you yelling numbers at me all night? When I was a kid, my Uncle Herman was a house painter, and whenever he had no work no more, then he came and slept on the sofa in our parlor. I loved my Uncle Herman. I really loved him. And one time, I tell my mom, I want to be a painter, just like my Uncle Herman. And my sister Norma laughed, and she said, Charlie's going to be the artist in the family. And then my dad slapped her face. And he said, don't be so nasty to your brother. And I felt bad. You know, I don't know what an artist is, but if Norma got slapped for saying it, mustn't be a nice thing. I always felt bad when Norma got slapped for being mean to me. When I get smart, I want to go visit her.
I wouldn't believe it if I saw it with my own eyes. So, the Russian ballet's performance.
Look at this, Mrs. Daughter.
I'm looking. I'm seeing when I'm not believing. How come Charlie is working the dough mixing machine?
I was at the lunch. It's Frank's idea of an April Fool's joke.
I pay you to make April Fool's an expensive machine.
Well, Oliver quit yesterday. The machine was just sitting there. I thought it was...
Where's yesterday? It took Oliver 6 months to learn, and he went to baker school.
What happened to Charlie?
Well, I don't really know what I see. You a new man?
You even said maybe next week.
Well...
You think he could do it?
He does it better than Oliver.
Charlie, darling, what are you doing?
Well, I didn't mean nothing, Mrs. Donner. I only...
Nobody
well,
said you
Frank
meant
said
anything,
I...
Charlie. Now, how did you learn that?
Well... I always watch Oliver done it, so I did it.
I don't want to be unreligious or anything, but it's like a miracle.
I told you there was something peculiar about Charlie.
Oh, bring the cheesecake out of the oven. Mrs. Dawn, 7 years I've been coming here, so I'm ready to complain about the noodle pudding you sold me last Friday. What could be the matter with the noodle pudding? Too many noodles. In noodle pudding, what were you expecting? Macaroons? Raisins. Where were the raisins I asked? Gina, would you get Mrs. Feldman a piece of noodle pudding on the house?
And a cupcake for my cleaning girl. What's she know if one's good for me?
Charlie, Alan, I don't know how you've done it, but it looks like you finally learned something. I want you to apply yourself. You were very hot, but you got yourself a new job in a $5 raise.
Well, I don't want a new job, Mrs. Donner. I like my old job, where I can clean up with my friends, Frank and Joe.
Well, Never mind your friends, Charlie. You should want to work and advance yourself.
Well, what's advanced?
Never mind. No matter how much I need to lose your job. That's advanced. Oh, oh, Mr. Riley. I thought you should meet our new mixer. That was one April Fool's joke that backfired.
Tell me the joke, Frank. The one that
backfired. Fire, go soak your head. Try up.
Well, does this mean I'm getting smarter?
What's this?
Charlie's progress reports for April 9th. It was the day I gave the punctuation lesson, and there's a comma after every word.
His progress is remarkable. His IQ's 100, and I really think we'll reach 150 in a few weeks.
He's going so quickly. I've got him reading novels and history, and his arithmetic is almost high school level. In a week or so, I think we'll be able to begin a foreign language.
What's he reading?
Robinson Crusoe.
And he understands?
Yes. He was terribly upset, though, when Crusoe was alone but quite relieved when he called Friday.
Yes, he seems to have a fixation on loneliness.
He's always been alone.
That's right. What will you give him next?
Perhaps some of the modern classics, Grapes of Wrath, Look Home, an Angel.
Excellent. Now, our problem will occur when he gets to the college level. He mustn't be allowed to read any psychology. It will confuse him and have him thinking about psychological theory instead of his own thoughts and feelings.
I'm afraid there's going to be another problem when he reaches college level.
What?
Me. I don't think I'll be able to keep ahead of him.
Well, we'll cross that bridge when we have to. It'll be a shame, though. He's very attached to you. You're almost a mother figure to him.
If I'd wanted to become a mother, Professor, I would have married and become a mother.
Well, Strauss says he's progressing very well in therapy. He's beginning to dream.
That can't be very pleasant.
No, it's odd. He remembers certain events in the bakery and his sister Norma, but he can't recall his parents' names or even their faces.
I can't help but wonder what kind of people his parents were like. I mean, there's such an essential goodness and openness to Charlie. He was their child. I mean, how could they have sent him off to an institution?
Well, there are pressures.
If it wasn't for Mrs. Donner, his uncle, Charlie would have sunk lower and lower and become a vegetable. What a waste.
Miss Kenyon! Miss Kenyon! I beat Algernon.
That's wonderful, Charlie.
I never even knowed I beat him until Burr Selvin told me. And then I got so excited the second time I lost. But then I beat him 8 times in a row.
Excellent news, sir.
I must be getting smart to beat a smart mouse like that.
Yes, sir.
And then Burr let me hold him. And I felt bad because I beat him. And I wanted to make friends. And I asked if I could feed him, but Bert said no.
Well, Charlie, Algernon is a special mouse. When he wants to eat, he has to solve a new problem to get his food.
Well, how would you like to pass a test every time you were hungry?
Me? No, I have a PhD.
Charlie, did you finish all this number yourself?
Yeah, I liked it. But what happens after the story?
What do you mean?
Now, after the book's over, what happens next?
Charlie, that's it. There is nothing after.
Well, why?
Charlie, when an author writes a book, he has a beginning and an end, and then he finishes. And then he writes another story.
Well, can I read that one?
Charlie, there isn't another story. Here, I brought you some books. How's everything else going?
Well, swell. I got an advance at the bakery.
I know. I've read any reports.
You read them?
Yes. Keep up with how you're getting on.
Well, it's funny. I kept writing them, and I didn't know people was reading them, or you.
Does that bother you?
No, it's just I write everything in these, even the things I think about, and some things that I won't maybe want you to know.
Charlie, there's nothing to be ashamed of. You're a fine person, and you're going to show them all one day.
Show them what?
I mean, for someone God gave so little to, you've done more than people who have always had brains and never used them. I just don't want you to be upset when you find out that not everyone is as smart or as nice as you think.
No, people are nice, Miss Kenyon. Everyone's nice to me. You're nice, and Dr. Strauss is nice. Everybody's really nice. And also, no one would ever be mean to me. That's silly. Nobody ever did nothing that was mean.
I think we're done for now. Try the books, Charlie.
What's wrong?
Nothing, Charlie. I'm fine.
April 15th. Miss Kinnean is a nice lady. Like my mom used to be, I think. I remember my mom told me to be good and always be friendly. But I should be careful because sometimes people would think I was making trouble and they'd laugh at me. I remember when my mom brought my baby sister back from the hospital. I still don't know why you get the babies at the hospital.
She was nice, like a baby doll.
Only she cried all the time. I remember my dad once said, "Don't worry, Charlie wouldn't hurt her." They put her in a crib in their room, and one night,
they was arguing in the kitchen, and she was crying, and I'm in bed, and I only wanted to make her stop crying.
Don't you ever touch her again! She's a baby! You'll hurt her!
Well, she thought I was gonna hurt the baby.
I've never hurt the baby. I'll tell Dr. Strauss that I remembered tomorrow night. No, not tomorrow. Tomorrow night, Frank is giving me a party at the bakery because of the new job I got.
Hey, Joe, turn on the stereo so we can dance.
How's that?
Don't you, Charlie?
She's nice.
You ever kiss him?
No, you don't kiss teachers, Frank.
I hate that Charlie Gordon too much. Oh, here you are, Charlie. A nice cold drink.
Oh, thanks. What is it?
Oh.
It tastes funny.
What did you give him?
Oh. Why'd you dance with Ellen, Charlie? Come on!
Oh, no, I feel funny.
Oh, go on.
Frank, stop.
Well, I never danced with the girl before.
You're doing great, kid.
Whoa.
Cut it out, Frank!
You're fine.
Sorry, Frank.
Charlie, do me a favor, will you, kid?
Sure.
Why don't you run down to the deli and grab us some sandwiches? You know, corned beef, turkey, and maybe some potato salad.
Yeah, and I'll get some pickles.
Dude, okay. Okay, look. Why don't we all go get my car and head up to Luigi's for some pizza?
But Aegis and Charlie have to go get sandwiches.
You know I don't eat corned beef. Come on.
That's not nice. This was supposed to be his party.
He's a drag on the party. We can't have any fun with Charlie around. Come on. There's always a lot of action with Luigi's. April 16th. Now I know what it means when they say to pull a Charlie Gordon. I'm ashamed. I never knew before that Frank and Joe liked to have me around just to make fun of me. I guess it's a good thing to find out. Why do they think a dumb person is so funny? They wouldn't laugh at a cripple.
Good morning, Charlie. Professor Nimrod Lecker Rorschach. You've seen these cards before, remember?
Yes, I remember.
Is anything wrong, Charlie?
No, it's just those cards upset me.
There's nothing to be upset about. Now, look at this one. What might this be? What do you see on this card? People see all sorts of things in these ink blots. Tell me what it might mean for you, or what it makes you think of.
You mean there are no pictures in the ink blots?
What?
Pictures in the ink blots. Last time you told me that there were pictures that everybody could see and that you wanted me to find them too.
No, Charlie, I couldn't have said that.
Yes, that's exactly what you said. And I'm tired of everybody making fun of me. Just because you're smart enough to go to college doesn't mean you have to make fun of me all the time.
Charlie, wait a minute. What's this all about?
I'm sick and tired of everybody laughing at me and people making fun of me.
Everyone's making fun of me.
Maybe before it was okay, but now I know the difference.
Bert, set up a take for the first test. Look, Charlie, do you want to hear the exact words Bert used?
But today he said there are pictures in the cards
Charlie,
that he wanted me
Charlie,
to find.
Charlie, the procedures have to be the same each time you perform the test or the results are invalid. They will not be accurate.
I'll believe it when I hear it.
People see all sorts of things in these ink blots. Tell me what it makes you think of.
Somebody spilled the ink on a white card.
Was that really me?
I figured out a new way to set up the mixing machines at the bakery, and Mrs. Donner was very pleased. She said it speeds up production, and she gave me a $50 bonus and a $10 raise. But why don't I enjoy working there anymore, Doctor?
Why, you tell me?
I don't know. Well, actually, Frank and Joe, they ignore me. No, it's more than that. They're hostile to me. They're supposed to be my friends, but it takes the pleasure all out of this. Why?
Well, the more intelligent you become, the more problems you'll have.
Why didn't you tell me that before the operation?
Would you have understood?
Your intellectual growth is going to outstrip your emotional growth, so there will be problems. That's why I'm here.
I guess I need you then.
How are your studies going?
Oh, fine. The French is going well. The German is a little more difficult. I'd like to try Russian.
Why?
Well, I'd like to see what War and Peace is like in the original.
You enjoyed it in English?
I read it all night.
You read War and Peace in one night?
Uh-huh.
Well, then certainly you don't have time for dreams.
Oh, but I do, Doctor. There's hardly a moment of sleep where I don't dream.
How about what?
Well, last night it was Charlie. Before Norma was born, he's around 6 or 7, and he's playing with his spinner. It's bright colored blocks on a top, and...
Is he alone?
Well, no. I see my mom, and I see her hair, but I can't see her face. I just can't recognize it. And I see my dad, too. And I recognize his form and his shape, but I don't see his face either. He has a file in his hands.
Special essential form. Another $25.
Don't tell me about the money. What did he say?
The same thing that everyone else, including the principal, said. That he would be better
off at another
school.
I'm not setting him away.
School.
He's mine. There's nothing wrong with him.
Rose, there is no good in pretending nothing is wrong here.
He's not a dummy. He's normal. He's just like anyone else. Charlie, put that thing away. Go play with your alphabet blocks.
For God's sake, stop yelling at him. You're scaring him.
Me? I'm scaring him? He's my son. I can make him... Charlie, you're going to be sick? Charlie, go to the bathroom.
God's sake, leave him alone. You always do this. The poor
then
kid
why
just
don't you help me, Matt? I have to do it all by myself. Every day I try to teach him, to help him catch up with the others. He's just slow, that's all. But he can learn like anyone else.
You're fooling yourself. Pretending he's normal, driving him like he's a dog that can learn to do tricks. It's not fair to us or to him. Why can't you just leave him alone?
Because I want him to be like everyone else.
Look at him!
Next time,
look at Charlie, he's gonna be sick!
Why did you just let yourself see the truth? Principal, even the teacher said he is not capable of doing the work
that
in a
teacher?
Regular
that's
classroom.
A retarded one. Let her start with me again. I'll do more than break the Board of Education. Inside. Go inside.
Take him. He's
keep
right
out of this. He has got to learn to take care of himself. Charlie, you're a big boy now. You'll be punished. I'm not cleaning up. Charlie, you are bad, bad, bad.
I think that's all for today, Charlie.
Doctor, I remember their names. She was Rose, and he was Matt. I remember their names. I want to ask Miss Kinnian for a date. I want to ask Alice for a date. Why am I afraid to ask her? I asked Dr. Strauss whether or not I should, and he said that it's a decision I have to make on my own. I decided. I want to. Why don't I? Well, the studies are going well. The Russian and the calculus. There's so much work to do. I can hardly sleep. And my sleep is fitful. There are just so many dreams. I can see my parents' faces now.
Said to him.
I can take care of my own dog.
Feed and wash and take him out.
I help too.
No, it's not be mine.
You see?
But we have to share things, dear. Charlie can help you take care of it.
No, it's got to be mine. I'm the one who got an A in history, and if I can't have it for myself, then I don't want it.
That settles it. No dog.
I hate.
Norma, stop that at once.
And I hate school. I'll stop studying and forget everything, and I'll be a dummy just like him. It's happening now. Forget it.
What do I do? Call Dr. Portman and let him tell me to put Charlie in the Warren home?
No, be hasty.
Hasty? It feels like 100 years I've lived with this. What do we know? Maybe it has a bad effect on a child to grow up with someone like him in the house.
He tries. The boy tries.
I know he tries. But he can't. Think of her life. She's growing up. Who will she meet? Who can she bring to the house with a brother like that?
Now that you've got her, you decide you don't want him anymore.
Do you think it's easy? Half of them say put him away, half of them say do anything to keep him, and what do you say? Nothing. Express an opinion for what?
I don't! He's my son, too. I gave you all of that money for the doctors and specialists. All of that money. I could have had a shot by now.
Is the money all you can think of?
I think of her. I try to think of him. And I think about us. What is this doing to us?
Matt, I cannot stand much more.
So much to do.
The university has put me in a separate room in the library because it only takes me a second to absorb a printed page.
and the curious students like to watch me flip through books. Well, now I'm doing etymologies on ancient languages, newer works on the calculus of variations, and Hindu history. I'm also taking Alice on a date to the Philharmonic concert in Central Park tonight. But why am I so tense?
Mama, Charlie Butler pegging me. Make him go away.
Alice is an attractive woman. She's not married, and there's nothing wrong with wanting
you
to.
You keep away from your sister's friends. You hear me, Charlie? You gotta keep away from those girls. You go near a girl, I'll put you in a cage for the rest of your life. You hear me, Charlie? You hear me?
I hear you! Shouldn't we be closer? I think it would be
no reason to be right on top of the orchestra.
What about over there?
This is fine, Charlie. Why are you so edgy?
I'm sorry. It's just that. What's that they're playing?
Debussy's La Mer. He was a French composer who lived in.
Oh. School lets out at 3:00.
I'm sorry. I'm so proud of you. You've accomplished a lifetime of learning and weeks. I just hope to God you don't get hurt.
Oh, I should be fine. I mean, as long as Algernon's smart, I should be fine intellectually, at least.
Well, what does that mean?
Nothing. Dr. Strauss says he's sure nothing can go wrong.
I hope so. I feel so responsible.
Well, I never would have done it if it hadn't been for you.
Did I do the right thing?
Of course, Alice, I like you.
I like you too, Charlie.
I like you very much. Alice, why can't I put into words the way I feel?
Don't, Charlie, not yet.
Well, it's like I'm trying to say that I
shouldn't have come here, Charlie. I have no right to put this on a personal or emotional level. You've got obligations to Strauss and to Niebuhr and to all those who may follow after you.
Well, I'm not something in a test tube, Alice.
Charlie,
I'm
just
a man.
Wait. And finish your studies.
I should be able to say that I love you.
Up until now, I've been your teacher, Charlie. You're bound to think you're in love with me.
You're saying little boys always fall in love with their teachers.
That's
and emotionally I'm still a little boy.
No, Charlie.
Just because I'm growing intellectually doesn't mean that I'm not gonna still have feelings for you.
Charlie, just please don't push me. When you mature intellectually, you may not even be able to communicate with me. When you mature emotionally, you may not even want me.
Alice,
I've got to think of myself too.
It's not going to change anything. Alice. I like you a lot, and I just don't understand why you're pretending that I'm not here.
No, I'm trying to pretend I don't care that you are here, but I do.
Stop that!
Charlie!
Come back here!
Charlie, are you alright?
Did you see him?
Charlie!
Right there, close enough to touch. Did you see that?
Hey, are you okay?
Alice. The truth.
Charlie.
Did you see him?
It was too dark.
Right there.
I'm sure there was someone. I just couldn't see. I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have taken you here. I need to take you home. I'm trying my best, Mrs. Donner.
Nobody saved your wife, Charlie, but something's happened to you and I don't understand. Nobody does.
But
my place is upside down. I had last night another delegation from the staff. Charlie, I got my business together. I can let you go.
go? Where do you expect me to go? What am I supposed to do?
Oh, you know as well as me you don't need to work here anymore.
Well, what do you want from me, Mrs. Donner? I can work harder.
Let's face it, Charlie. You're not the same Charlie from 17 years ago, and you're certainly not the same Charlie from 3 months ago. Maybe you haven't told me. So I don't ask, but maybe a miracle, who knows, but you've changed to a very smart young man. And working the dough mixing machine is no work for a very smart.
But you said that as long as I needed the job here, I could have it.
If you did, Charlie, I'd stand up for you against all them and their petitions, but they're scared to death of you, Charlie. You're scared, maybe jealous, who knows, but they won't work with you and try all they got. Business. Come and stay a little sometime.
Algernon back in the cage with all of the other mice, what would happen to him?
He will. Besides, I've already informed the committee that we're presenting the paper at Chicago.
You're wrong, Harold. June 15th is 2 weeks from now. It's too soon.
We've stated the pattern correctly so far, and we are justified in making an interim report.
It is too important to all of us to bring it out prematurely in
but
front
if
of the
you
top men
now,
in the field. You're not the only one with the reputation to consider. If something should go wrong now, we'll
I'm
all
not
be lacking
of
production
anymore. I've checked and rechecked everything. Nothing can go wrong.
Wait, just wait. You're not thinking about the experiment. You're thinking about the sheriff's psychology at Halston.
That's
well, what
you are riding in the coattails of my psychological research.
It is my techniques in psychosurgery and enzyme injection patterns that are the important.
But you never have found the word for my
wait,
original theory.
Wait, just wait. What is the rush? You're like a child.
I am not a child. I am the senior member of this project, and we're taking Charlie and Algernon to Chicago.
June 7th. I hate the nights after the university library closes. There's nowhere to go. Most nights I just walk. Last night I walked all over the city so that I wouldn't have to go home and go to sleep. I have nightmares constantly. Alice has called and left messages for me all over. I want to see her so bad. I can't call her, but I'm just so afraid I'll see Charlie too. She'll be at work now. I've got to talk to somebody. You're a nice machine. I like talking to you more than I like talking to Dr. Strauss. He doesn't have an erase button.
Good night, Miss Kinnean. Good night, girls.
Look, Bernice. It's Charlie.
Where you been, Charlie? That's a nice suit.
Hello, Connie. Bernice. Alice. Stupid grin.
No,
thank you very
a
much.
A real smile because you wanted people to like you, Charlie. Now, with all your knowledge.
All right! I've changed. But that doesn't mean I have to take the kind of treatment I've had all my life.
People have not been bad to you.
What do you know about it? The best of them have been smug and patronizing.
I suppose. suppose you put me in that category too.
Don't be stupid, Alice.
I must seem rather dull-witted to you.
What is that supposed to mean?
You're destroying my self-confidence. I called you after the concert, not once, but a dozen times. And I've never come to command before and need you an answer. All right, Charlie Gordon, I'm not as smart as you are. I don't know cultural variants and neo-Boolean mathematics. It made me feel slow and dense, and I have to remind myself I'm not losing my own knowledge. You move me forward so quickly.
Why do we have to talk here? Can I take you somewhere else? Alice, I needed somebody to talk to.
Where were you when I needed somebody to talk to, Charlie?
It's the way I feel. I'm
what
sorry.
What about the way I feel? I don't care if your IQ is 185 or hasn't gone up since the last time I saw you. Charlie, you don't understand me or what I feel or how I feel or why I feel. But I'm sorry. I should have upset you. You've got to go to the convention. You'll be under the street.
Well, you'll have to see me there at the convention.
I called you and told you.
No, Alice.
Interesting, intelligent people for you to talk to, Charlie. You'll be in the spotlight.
No, you have to come. Everything I've done for you. You've been a big part of everything I've achieved.
No matter what
please.
You say, I know that's all.
Please, Alice.
Charlie,
just
we need time and distance to figure out what this is. So if you don't mind, I'll go home now and hold on to my splintery ego. Have another good convention, Charlie. There's no bus.
He's not my real brother. My mama told me. He's just a boy we took in because we felt sorry for him. How silly. Charlie doesn't really belong here.
The next presentation really needs no introduction. We've all heard about the startling experimental work being done at Beekman University, sponsored by the Wellberg Foundation, and under the direction of Professor Harold Niebuhr and Dr. Jay Strauss. This is the report we've all been anxious to hear, so let me turn this meeting over to Dr. Strauss.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That chair lady, why didn't she just say, step right up and see the sideshow? See the performing white mouse and the moron change to geniuses before your very eyes for only, a tenth of a trauma and a thin brain neurosis.
Stop it, Charlie. This is the big moment.
For who? Well, why are they laughing? What are they laughing at?
There are movies, Charlie. You were, we made a movie.
I was filmed? You never told me I was filmed. Why are they laughing? That was a man in torment.
White. When Charlie came to us, he was outside of society. With no friends, no family, no mental equipment to live a normal life, no past, no connection to the present, no hope for the future. It might be said that Charlie Gordon did not really exist before this experiment. Now, may I present my colleague, Professor Harold Niebuhr.
How dare you? I am a human being, a person with family, and a memory, and I was before you wheeled me into that operating room.
But has the mouse retained his new mental capacity with no variation?
Well, not exactly. At the peak of his intelligence so far, Algernon occasionally varies. Sometimes he will refuse to do work, and other times he'll solve a problem, but instead of taking his award, he'll hurl himself against the wall of the maze.
Why wasn't I told that? That
not
is very
now,
important.
Charlie.
But we believe the behavior is unique to Algernon, as it had never occurred in any of the other mice.
But none of the other mice have achieved Algernon's level of intelligence, Doctor.
So we have every reason to believe that Charlie's and Algernon's cure will be permanent.
But how have you determined that, Professor?
By statistical evaluations based on earlier experiments. Normally dull mice, made normally intelligent, retain that condition for the lifespan. However, with Algernon, we were back to more successful, and Charlie's intellect has increased to a genius level.
That doesn't prove anything, Doctor. Your calculations are premature.
What do you mean?
It's one thing to hold a minor increase of intelligence for a lifespan, but in a case where the intelligence has been enormously increased, the waiting period must be extended. We've gone up faster, so we'll be going down faster, way before the end of a lifespan.
So now, in place of a feeble-minded shell, a burden on society, you must fear his irresponsible behavior. We have a man of dignity and sensitivity ready to take his place.
You don't really know if Algernon's and mine intelligence are permanent, do you?
I don't know. We may have presented too soon. What you say, you may have spotted a mistake.
Sorry, Doctor, it's just my superior intelligence.
I should like you all to hear a few words from Charlie Gordon.
Algernon's loose!
Get him!
Behind that curtain!
Close the door! Hurry!
Go ahead, Lapdope. You don't know, the whole experiment could be in danger.
Oh, don't be so upset about it, Doctor. Like he said, you may have spotted the mistake, and it may not matter after all.
Have you got him?
You and me now, Algernon. You won't have to solve any more problems to be fed. I always resent that. We've got to get to work as quickly as possible. We're going to leave on the next train to New York, and I've got to find my parents. I've got to get started on this next bit of research. We may not have as much time as we thought we did.